Hey guys, it's Mr. Crayfish and welcome back to another Furniture Mod update. This update today is insane because it adds in 56 new blocks into Minecraft. Let's check it out now, shall we? You heard me correct, 56 new blocks added across 4 new pieces of furniture. We've also got brand new blocks never seen before in the furniture mod. So if you guys are excited for today's video, I'd appreciate if you'd go ahead, drop a like down below, and as well subscribe and turn on that bell if you want to keep up to date with every single furniture mod update. But let's get into this right now. Alrighty, let's get into this right now. And something a little bit different about these videos is that the inspiration will now be at the last part of this instead of in between each furniture we actually look at. But I'm actually really excited for this update today because it actually adds in something completely brand new, something that wasn't in the 1.12 version of this mod. So that gives you even more reason to start upgrading to 1.14. But let's go ahead, let's start this off, let's take a look what is in the first chest here, and we have the upgraded fences. They're back in the mod. Let's grab them all out, and we've got the standard 6, but we've also got the brand new stripped variants of them, something that is new in this 1.14 version of the furniture mod. Let's go ahead, let's check them out right now. So these have a brand new model as well. They are still very similar to the old one, but they definitely look a lot better now. They definitely look a lot better in my opinion in this version of the mod. So as you can see, we can place them down like that. So they're essentially, you know, upgraded fence. As you can see here, we have the regular oak fence, and then over here we have the upgraded version. So as you can see, the upgraded one looks a lot more decorative rather than the original one from Minecraft. But let's go ahead, let's check out the rest of them here. So that was the oak. We have the spruce. So something that is cool about this is they no longer join up to like different types. So if you want, you can actually place fences directly next to each other like that. We have birch, the jungle ones, acacia, and then finally the dark oak. And then next up we have the stripped variants. I like these. This is definitely definitely one of my favorite parts of the mod now, is these new stripped variants, because they're just like a more clean look. So here we have the oak, the stripped oak, stripped spruce, the birch, jungle, acacia, and then finally the dark oak. How amazing do all these fences look? Now, how do you actually craft them? Well, it's quite simple. Now, I'm actually going to get out the ingredients because I just realized there's actually a piece of furniture in there that we haven't looked at yet, and I don't want to spoil it right now. So let's grab out some sticks and let's grab out some logs, and I'm sure you guys are really familiar already with how you actually craft fences. So instead of using the planks, you actually use the logs instead. Put the sticks in the middle and that will give you 12 of the upgraded fences. So just change around the oak to a different type of log, or even the stripped logs, and then that will give you the upgraded fence. So we can grab that out, and there we go. Now, I'm not done yet with these. Something that is really cool about these upgraded fences, unlike the regular fences in Minecraft, is they actually look good when they are stacked two or more blocks high. So if I go ahead and I've just got the regular oak fence here, if I was to create like a, you know, let's say 3 block high fence there. And as you can see, the upgraded fence looks so much better than the normal fences. And something that I can point out here is that we don't actually have posts in the middle. So you can see on here, we actually only have the post on the end of the fence rather than actually in the middle here like the normal Minecraft fences. And it would be most notable if we actually go ahead and we grab just the kind of regular oak upgraded fences, and we do this. So as you can see, the posts are actually only at the end of the fence rather than in the middle. So to complement the upgraded fences, we have the upgraded gates. So let's take a look at how these work right now, and they are designed to be used with the upgraded fences. So I'm gonna go ahead, let's grab the oak upgraded fence here, and let's just create a little bit of an enclosed area over here so we can test these out properly. Now, if you were to use the original gate, it won't actually work, and it wouldn't look good anyway if you were to actually use it. So you need to get yourself one of these upgraded gates, and how you actually use these is depending on what side you actually place it on the block is where the hinge is going to go. So I want the hinge to be on the right side, so let's place it there. And as you can see, the fence now connects up to it, and we have a gate. So we simply right click the front of it to open it. We can now walk through, close it again simply by right clicking it, and there we go. And something that is really cool about this new upgraded gate is that the door will open in the direction that you're actually looking. So if I was to exit this enclosed area now, the door is actually going to open towards the outside of it. And then when we go back in here, as you can see, it opens inwards. And that is just a really small feature about this. And it's a bit of a, you know, a quality of life improvement. It just feels a lot more natural that the door opens, you know, in the direction that you're going. And like the 1.12 version, you can still create double gates. So here we have a double gate, and we right click it, and it will open both of the gates at the same time, and of course in the direction you are looking as well, which is really cool. But let's head out here, let's take a look at all the other variants right now. So we have all the different types of wood variants for these. So we have the oak, what am I doing there? Alright, we have the oak, spruce, birch, jungle, acacia, dark oak, stripped oak, spruce, stripped spruce, birch, and then we have the remaining ones, the jungle, acacia, and then the dark oak. They all look absolutely amazing. Let's go ahead, let's go through these right now so we can just go, oh, whoopsie, I must have placed the acacia one a little bit wrong. There we go. Oh, I placed like all of them wrong. What am I doing here? All right, here we go. Oh my God. That's kind of cool. Hey, look at that. Hey, I just made like a fence. Look at that. I made like a little bit of a gate fence. That's interesting. Maybe that could be used somehow. I don't know. Maybe you guys can figure out how you can use that in your own builds. All right, let's close that. And just like the upgraded fences, they can be stacked as well. So when we create a double high one here, it looks really nice. And when you right click one of them, it will open up all the doors, not just the one to the left of them. It will open the ones below as well. So that is a really cool feature about these upgraded gates. And then in order to craft these upgraded gates, you can actually use any sort of fence gate that you want. You don't actually have to use the type. All you need to choose is the type of log that you want. So this can be birch, it can be spruce, it can be a stripped log, and that will give you two upgraded gates. So many amazing things so far, but this next piece of furniture we're going to take a look at is going to be a bridge onto this next chest, which is the new stuff that I'm talking about. It is brand new, completely brand new, never been in any of the previous furniture mods at all, so get excited for that. But in this box we have the white picket fence. So straight from 1.12 we had a white fence, and now it's back in the furniture mod for 1.14. So these use the same model as the upgraded fences, but it is a more of a plain look. So it's just using a simple white texture here. And this is something that you would normally see maybe out the front of somebody's house. They might have like a hedge that goes along the front of it like this. It's a really nice look if you're creating a home that's not modern, but, you know, aesthetically pleasing, and these fences definitely look really nice to surround your house with. But I want to move on to the next chest, because this is where the furniture mod steps up its game. You can now get the white picket fence in every single color. So every single dye color you can get the fence in. So we have white, we have orange, we have magenta, we have everything. So this allows you guys to expand your creative, what? Can I speak? Creativity was the word I was looking for. It allows you to expand your creativity even more, because you have all the different colors and they can be used for so many different things. Not only fences, they can be used as poles, they can be used as ways to organize, maybe like sheep or something like that. And I will show you guys some inspiration at the end of this video. So we have every single color. It's amazing. Let's go ahead, let's place them all down right now so you guys can get a really nice look at them all. But have a look at these. How amazing do all these colors look? This is actually something that I remember like a couple of people suggesting in 1.12, but it just, I don't know why I didn't really want to add it until now. I think it's that 1.14 is a lot easier to add in new blocks compared to 1.12. And again, just like the upgraded fences, because they're using the same model, they can actually be stacked up and they look like a really nice fence. But let's go on to the crafting recipe of this, because it's actually quite simple. So all you need to do is get some concrete, get some sticks, and then it's just like a regular fence where you put two on either side there, put the sticks in the middle, and that will give you the picket fence. So change around the white concrete to any color that you want. But let's say you accidentally create some white fences, but you were meaning to create some yellow ones. Well, now you can actually dye them again in the crafting table, and you can actually use any sort of picket fence you want. So I've got a bit of a combination here. I've got some light blue ones, I've got a lime one, and I've got some orange ones here. And as you can see, we surround the dye with the fences and it gives us 8 yellow picket fences. So it allows you to reuse them and not have to actually craft brand new ones. And of course, to go along with the new colored picket fences, we have also the colored picket gates. So let's grab all these out right now. So let's place all these down. So I'm just going to place them on the side here. So we have the white, the orange, magenta, light blue, yellow, lime, pink, gray, light gray, cyan, purple, blue, brown, green, red, black, and there we go. We can open them all up now. That was actually really fun. But these are really cool, because unlike the these can be used in the same way as well, but these can actually be used as doors if you really want to. So if we go over here to Craig here and we just destroy that for a second, if we go ahead and we just place them kind of like in this sort of fashion, we actually have some doors now, and we can right click them, we can open it up, we can close them. So not only can they be used as gates, they could be used as doors. We could have a single door if you really wanted to as well. So this would be really cool if you had lots of different rooms, because now you can kind of label them with a door color. And then to craft these gates, it's quite simple. So it's just like crafting the upgraded gates. We simply have two concrete of your choice on either side, put the gate in the middle, and that will give you the picket gate. Yo, can someone clean up an aisle outside of Craig here? This road is literally blocked off now by all the new blocks we've added in this new update. It is crazy. But I think it is time to move on to the inspiration, and I'm going to show you guys how you can actually use these pieces of furniture, not for their normal purpose, but in really cool ways. Kind of like furniture mod hacks. So let's check it out right now. So I have some awesome inspiration lined up for you guys. I have 3 examples today instead of 2. So let's just go ahead, get straight into it. So this first one here, I love. This was actually suggested by one of you guys. I can't remember who said it in the comments, but they wrote it down and I was like, that's amazing. I definitely have to let you guys know about this. And this is creating a hot tub using the brand new sofas. So as you can see here, we have sofas in the middle in a kind of like a 3x3, and we've filled it up with water because every piece of furniture in my furniture mod can be waterlogged. So you can actually put a bucket of water on here and we can sit in here like it's an actual hot tub, and we got steam as well coming up from the water. We actually have a fire underneath here with a glass block on top, so it's kind of imitating steam. I mean, if you think about it in terms of the fire, it would be smoke, but I like to think of this as steam coming up from the water. And then we're actually taking advantage of the new upgraded fences here as a support beam for the roof at the top there. And then we've got a little bit of a privacy barrier at the back here, so I've just stacked up the upgraded fences to 3 blocks high, and it actually acts as a really nice decoration piece, as well as a privacy barrier. It just has a very aesthetically pleasing feel to this entire build, so take this however you like, build a hot tub. So I definitely recommend taking this design and building it in your world, or you can change it up however you like. Another way that I actually like to do it is simply just by creating a 3x3 like this. You get the trapdoors. You can get any sort of trapdoors that you would like. This is really up to you. It's just a little bit of inspiration. So I like to put trapdoors around like that. And then if we go ahead and we grab these spruce stairs, place them at the back here like this. This is a much more sort of like compact version of it. And then simply grab a bucket of water and then just fill this up like so. And there you go, you instantly have a hot tub. And then if you want to do exactly what I did with the fireplace, just get a campfire, grab some glass, dig 2 blocks down in the middle there, place the fire, place the glass, and there you go, you now have steam coming up from the hot tub. The next example I have here is an outdoor setting. So in this one, I am mainly taking use of the upgraded fences here by using them as some support poles for the roof at the top here. These are actually campfires just with the fire removed. And then at the back here, we're using a lot of the upgraded fences to create a sort of a wall slash privacy barrier. We've got these kind of windows here using the brand new upgraded gates. So if you need to open it up, maybe you just want to see into this garden that I got at the back here, you can do simply by right clicking it. And that is pretty much that is all being utilized in terms of the new furniture. We do have the stripped oak chairs here, and we have the stripped oak coffee table, but that is pretty much it. The rest of it is all vanilla like items. We've got a little bit of a barbecue there, and this is a really cool thing you can do, because like basically it matches up. What makes us look good is that these new upgraded fences can be used as a pole. This has got the oak log, so it matches up with the campfire wood texture, which is really nice. So you create like a nice little outdoor setting at the back of your house, or you can attach it to your house or do whatever you like. So hopefully this gives you some really awesome inspiration, but let's head on to the last one. Now, I said during the video the colored fences could be used for some sort of organization. So by using the fence colors as an indicator of what sheep is inside, you can actually create something that looks kind of, you know, pretty awesome in my opinion. So we have all the orange sheeps inside the orange fence, and I think you guys get the point. So this is just one example of how you can use these colored fences. There's definitely more ways, but this is just one of them that I thought of, and I thought I would share it with you guys. But that is going to end off this video today, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. And this update is available, so the download link will be in the description below. If you guys enjoyed this video and you haven't already, I'd appreciate if you go ahead, hit that like button, subscribe, turn on the bell notifications, and I will catch you guys for the next video. Bye!